Yes, graad 12, hoe gaan het daar by julle? Ons maak so 'n bietjie vandag 'n verandering in die skedule. Ons maak 'n Saterdag episode, a bit of a Saturday class. I'm busy with the last bit of preparation before I have to go back to school, so ek wil gaan ook reg maak voor ek weer terug aan school toe. So ek probeer my klas nou so vinnig as moontlik klaar maak, so dat as ek by die school kom, dat ek ons goed kan regkry vir die prakties, en dat ons gaan begin met hersiening vir ons September examen. So we're trying to get it done as quickly as possible with the theory, so when I go back to school I can start getting our workshop ready and we can start doing a revision on our old question papers before September. So these classes are going to get are going to get less book based and more old question paper based. We're still using Screencastify. Ons gaan gebruik weer die Screencastify vandag, so julle kan weer die handboek sien. En my gesig hier in die hoekie. So kom ons werk maar 'n bietjie deur. Ons is besig met besproeiing. Ons het laas hier gestop by kantrol besproeiing. Vandag kyk ons na controllers, zones en kleppotable controls, zones and let's see what the English version says. Control zones and valves. Most irrigation systems are divided in zones. A zone is a single irrigation valve and one or a group of sprinklers that are connected by pipes. Irrigation systems are divided into zones because there is usually not enough pressure and available flow to run sprinklers for the entire yard or sports field at once. Each zone has a solenoid valve on it and it's controlled by a wire by an irrigation controller. An irrigation controller is either mechanical, and now this is what they call the dinosaur type, the old one that you have to go turn the valve, or electrical device which signals a zone to turn on at a specific time and keep it on for amounted time. Smart controllers is a recent term used to describe a controller that is capable of adjusting the watering time by itself in response to current environmental conditions. The smart controller determines current conditions by means of historic weather data for a local area. A soil moisture sensor, water potential or water content, rain sensor, or in more sophisticated systems, satellite feed, weather stations, or a combination of these. So, in the English term now, you can't spray all of your farm at the same time. You must first get your irrigation system set up and then you go into zones. For instance, if I look on the farm in Piketberg, if I want to spray my apple trees in the morning, then I have to make sure that my water workers go and they turn on the valve. And we still use some of the dinosaur technology where we physically have to go turn the valve to make it spray. But all of the farms and most of the farms today, we're going to electronical ways, where you can actually just take your phone and say, right, but zone 4 is going to spray now. The reason why we have zones is your water pressure isn't enough to spray your whole farm. You might only have enough to spray a certain amount at a time. So that's why we put it in zones. And also to look at stuff like in places like Piketberg, which is very hot, for we don't lose water due to evaporation, because in Piketberg on a good day it's 41 and that's cold for us. So you want to spray at certain times of the day when you have the most water. So mense, wat gebeur is jou afdelings, jou plase besproeiingssisteme werk in zones. Maar uit elke zone het 'n klep op. Oké, okay, hulle praat van die solenoid klep wat beheer oor die besproeiingsbeheermeganisme. So daar's twee tipes meganismes wat ons nog gebruik. Die ou dinosaurus tipe waar die ou visie moet gaan in die kraan gaan oopdraai. Ek dink Rolof van daai manne wat nog van die plaas daar aan die Weskus, Erik, julle behoort dit nog te ken. Dan kry jy nou die nuwe tegnieke vir die groot boere waar hulle die goed sommer met die foon doen elektronies. Jy sit 'n timer op en jy sê 10 uur spuit die appelbome, 12 uur spuit die lemoenbome en so gaan ons aan. Die rede hoekom ons in zones werk is jou waterdruk is nie gewoonlik genoeg om die hele plaas op dieselfde tyd te spuit nie. So ons probeer maar afdeling spuit op 'n sekere tyd. Want as jy nou die hele plaas gaan probeer spuit, as jy nou sê jy 200 hektaar of 1500 hektaar gaan probeer spuit, gaan een deel die water kry en een deel gaan wel water kry. En die probleem met dit is, as jy goed die water kan nie vrek hulle, maar ongelukkig so nie. En jy kan ook jou water bestuur mooi toepas, as jy nie weet wat spuit wanneer. En ons kyk na goed soos verdamping, nee, as vat net ons in Mahamesbury of Boketberg waar dit lekker warm is, weet 41 op 'n koue dag, ou Adrian. Maar dis ongelukkig maar nou so dat ons maar die besproeiing moet doen volgens tye. Nou, wat is 'n besproeiingsklep? 'N Besproeiingsklep reguleer die rigting wat water vloei in 'n besproeiingsstelsel. Hierdie kleppe word gevind in die besproeiingsstelsels van gewasproduksie, parke, golfbane, grasperke. Hulle help met die beheer van water in die bogrondse sowel as ondergrondse sisteme. So wat is 'n irrigation valve? Irrigation valve is a valve that regulates one in the one directional flow of water in the irrigation system. The valve is often found in sprinkler systems used by parks, golf courses and home loans. They help control flow in the above ground systems as well as an in-ground system that have been buried well beneath the surface to present a less cluttered, more attractive landscape. So hierdie valves help om die water van punt A na punt B te kry, sodat dit terugvloei. What is an irrigation sprinkler? An irrigation sprinkler drops water onto the land, mimicking the effects of rain. Most sprinklers irrigation systems use a pipe or hose with the water traveling under pressure, which then escapes through sprinkler heads and is thrown or dropped to the ground. The basic means of delivering water, but the forms and irrigation sprinkler can take, is highly varied. Anyone considering an irrigation sprinkler should consider how big the area needs to be irrigated, as well as what shape the land is. Obstructions such as trees or rocks may require extra work for work to water around. How deep the soil needs to be watered should also be considered, along with how much time and effort is available to use the system. A sprinkler head is a distribution device attached to the end of a water pipe or a hose. The head is a device through which the water of a sprinkler system is discharged. There are different types of sprinkler heads. Available depending on where the sprinkler will be used, with a special design for a fire suppression sprinkler head. The sprinkler head is fairly small in size and is attached to a sprinkler mount with a central ring for the water flow. The top of the sprinkler head is a circular pipe with a series of fins or thin blades arranged in a circular pattern. When the sprinkler is activated, the water passes through the sprinkler head and changes the water flow from a steady stream to a circular arc shape. The water dispersion is designed to maximum the surface area that is reached by the water. There are two common applications of sprinkler heads: lawn sprinkler systems and fire suppression systems. Both uses the requirements are the same. The water needs to be distributed without any human intervention or adjustment. Through careful planning and design, it is possible to ensure that the total required area is covered. Lawn sprinkler heads can be reached around into the ground, and forced up by the pressure of the water. It's the pop-ups, basically the pop-up sprinklers that we have on our rugby field at Jan Kriel. The sprayer sprinkler head is designed to distribute heavy discharge rate in a short period of time. The sprinkler head is often designed with an inherent directional arm that forces the water to flow in a singular path. The type of sprinkler head is most commonly found on flat ground. Waar kry ons hulle gewoonlik? Nou, ons praat nou mooi van sprinkler irrigation, ons praat nou basies van besproeiingssprinkelaar. Daar's verskillende soorte. Ek het die hele ding in Engels afgelees, maar ons gaan op hierdie Afrikaans 'n bietjie condense, want dit is 'n dubbel werk wat ons nou gaan praat. So daar is meer as een tipe sprayer wat ons kan kry, sprayer koppies en goedjies. Hulle sê onthou net dat as jy jou grond spuit, moet jy kyk na obstruksies. Jy moet ook kyk vir die kop van die apparaat en al die mooi goedjies. Mense, afhangende van jou grond, die area wat jy moet spray en water wat jy het, gaan bepaal wat se tipe sprayer kop jy gaan gebruik. Jy kry van die spreekkoppe wat ons praat van pop-ups, wat jy nou al half in die grond in wegstik en die waterdruk stoot om op en dan spreek. En die spreeër se doel is om basies reendruppels na te maak. Om hierdie reendruppels na te maak sodat dat die effek van reën gee op die land. Ai. Hulle sê wanneer die spreeër geaktiveer word, vloei die water deur die spreeërkop wat dit verander in 'n stroom na 'n sirkelvormige patroon. Almal het hom gesien daarso. Nou die tipe wat gewoonlik gebruik in die plat, jammer. 'n Roterende sprinkelkop spuit water met 'n stadige spoed en dek 'n groter area oor 'n langer tydperk. Die tipe stelsel word gebruik op groot areas wat gereeld water nodig het as gevolg van grond en klimaatstoestande. Die keuse van die sprinkler van die sprinkelkop vereis beplanning vir die gebruik daarvan in 'n lang tydperk vir die instandhouding daarvan. Mense onthou, jy kan nie net loop besluit uit ek gaan die ene kies in. Ag gat ons hier. Jy moet eers 'n bietjie navorsing gaan doen. Bietjie navorsing gaan doen en gaan kyk wat se een werk vir my die beste. Gaan hierdie sprinkler wat ek nou wil opsit, die groot area van my spuit of het my as my area so klein en nou wil ek hierdie massiewe ding opsit. Jy moet maar bepaal. So guys, if you choose your sprinkler, you go look there we go. If you choose a router sprinkler head, it discharges water at a slower rate and covers wider area for a longer period of time. This type of system is most commonly found in large areas that require frequent watering due to soil and climate conditions. The selection of the type of sprinkler head requires some thought to the conditions over a long period of time and the amount of maintenance that will require. So, when I choose my sprinkler head, first of all, do I want it to spray a certain area? How big is my area? How much maintenance can I do? That's how you have to choose. In a fire separation system, the sprinkler head is attached to the ceiling with the top of the head facing down. Built into the sprinkler head is a heat sensitive bulb or a two-part metal link that is held together with an alloy. The bulb or metal lies across the top of the head and acts as a plug between the opening as a plug to keep the opening closed. So, a fire separation system is basically a fire alarm. That's how it looks. So, mense, die ander wat ons nou gaan kyk vir sprinklers, is as jy nou binne in jou plaas basies, of in jou werkswinkel op die opsit, is die vier demping sprayer. Die sprayerkop word in die plafon onderste bo vasgemaak en daar is 'n metaal koppelstuk wat baie hittesensitief is, wat die ding half as 'n prop funksioneer. So as dit 'n warm raak, gaan hy oop en as dit oop. Die instandhouding van sprayers is 'n relatiewe eenvoudige proses wat vervang en herstel insluit. Enige eienaar van 'n spreierstelsel wat hulle sê wat onkundig is met die herstel, kan 'n professionele persoon vra om te help. Baie besproeiingsondernemings bied 'n gratis jaarlikse instandhoudingsprogram aan wat lentetye maklik maak vir eienaars. So when we have to basically do maintenance on it, if you don't know how to do it, certain companies like Spillers here in Mamasbury will give you a maintenance plan where they will come and they will do maybe a yearly maintenance check on your system. Now, a few general questions that we ask. When will sprinkler irrigation be preferred above flood irrigation? When water supply is weak, surface steep leads to erosion. So basically you've got a steep surface. Infiltration tempo not constant, drainage problems and no high cost of leveling land. So, wanneer gaan ek nou kies teenoor as ek moet sprinkler vat teen 'n vloed? Baie maklik, as ek 'n swak water toevoer het, as ek teen 'n basiese snaakse gradiënt is, ek bly so half teen 'n bult, so ek gaan erosie kry as ek dit nie met vloed, so ek moet maar besproeiing met sprinkler doen. As ek 'n die drainage probleem was, ek kan nie die water vinnig genoeg uitkry my land uit nie. Wanneer my infiltrasie tempo nie konstant is, die een deel trek vinniger water as die ander een, as jy een deel het 'n dam en een deel het nie. En die ander ene is, dit is baie duur om grond gelyk te maak vir vloedbesproeiing. Onthou, vloedbesproeiing werk net as jou grond gelyk is. As dit nie gelyk is nie, dan maak jy nie vloedbesproeiing, dan maak jy net 'n plein bly die vloed, spoel jou mense weg. A sprinkler irrigation consists of four primary parts. List these primary parts: the engine or the electrical motor, the pump, the pipe, and the sprinklers. So jou sprinkler, jou sprinkler besproeiing bestaan uit 4 dele, jou pomp, jou pype, jou motor en ook jou sprinklers. Two types of sprinkler irrigation systems are illustrated below, A and B. Write the name of the irrigation method shown in B. Wat is B? Is 'n pivot. Wat is in Afrikaans nou weer? 'N spulpunt. My kop is vandag hier nie, 'n Saterdag, mense verskoon my. Onder watter omstandighede sal 'n stelsel genommer B 'n beter opsie wees as A? Wanneer gaan ek 'n spulpunt gebruik teenoor sproeier? Dit spaar tyd, to save time. Over greater areas, oor 'n groter area, onthou 'n spulpunt kan omtrent 200 hektaar doen en nie genoeg arbeid hê. We don't have enough manpower. I'll go to a pivot. Indien die makrobesproeiingsisteme nie effektief beheer word nie, sal dit 'n negatiewe invloed op die omgewing hê. Noem 3 van hierdie negatiewe effekte. Water word gemors, gronderosie en verbraking of sout word verhoog. So, if we don't do our irrigation effectively, 3 things will happen. We will waste water, we will have soil erosion, and we will also have a high increase in salt in our soil, which is not good for our plants. Noem 5 voordele van besproeiingssisteme, soos hierbo. Now, what is our 5 advantages of a pivot, a center pivot? It's a minimum arbeidskoste, low cost of workers, low working cost, low pump cost, low cost in pumps, low instandhoudingskoste, it's a low cost in maintenance, a long lifespan, a long lewensduur, in a hoë tweedehandse waarde, it has a high second hand value, you can sell it again. So one day when you decide, okay, I'm going to sell this pivot, you can still sell it. And the pivot can be taken apart and put back together again. Noem 'n manier om metaaldele van besproeiingsstelsels teen roes te beskerm. Galvanizing, galvanisering. How do I protect my system against rust? Galvanizing. Hoe kan diefstal van elektriese kabels behoed word? Nou, onthou hierdie goed met elektrisiteit. Hierdie kabel binne in die waterpyp te installeer. By installing the cable within the water pipe. Identifiseer die apparaat by die pompstasie waar 'n blokkade van sproeiers wil kom. At a pumping station there is a apparatus that stops blockages and it's called a sand filter, a sand filter. Die toutrekker sal weet, by Robertson het ons sandfilters gebruik aan die toutrekdromme as gewigte. Tamelike groot goedjies daai. Die gebruik van 'n self aangedrewe stelsel verteenwoordig die arbeids in die intensiewe taak om lande te voorsien van water. Die onderwys hulle vir jou foto van 'n besproeiingsstelsel beantwoord wat volg. Verduidelik waarom 'n besproeiingsstelsel in die arbeids sparend genoem word. Why is there low cost? Sorry, just quickly get my English is running out, looks like it. Here we go. Why is this irrigation system called a labor saving system? First of all, no labor is needed to ship the pipes or system. One man operation, automated watering system and scheduling, and fertilizers and pesticides are applied through the system. So hoekom is dit 'n lae arbeidskoste? Een braak kan dit werk. As jy mense nodig om die pype te skuif, jy gooi sommer kunsmis en gif binne in daai water en dit is alles geautomatiseer. Jy werk elektronies. Hy het 'n skedule. Give a reason for keeping the water pressure constant from the center of the pivot at the end of the pivot. So the quantity of water that has been administered to the cup can be equal from center of the land to the out edges. Hoekom moet die spulpunt se water op dieselfde druk die hele tyd wees sodat die water wat van die middel van die land dieselfde gespoel word uit die punt van die land en dit help die middel van die land kry 'n massiewe klomp water en dan nie by die punte waar die spulpunt daar agter kom maar net so klein bietjie druppels want die druk is te swak. The center pivot works on a basis of irrigation lines turns around the center pivot on wheels. The outer wheels of the system will turn much faster than the inner wheels. How is this quantity of water applied along the length of the pivot being regulated when it takes an unequal wheel speed in account? The inner nozzles are smaller and further apart than the outer nozzles. Die mense onthou, die pivot gaan baie vinniger draai aan die buitekant as aan die binnekant. Nou, hoe maak ons sodat almal op dieselfde hoeveelheid water kry? Baie maklik, jou binne spruiers is kleiner en hulle spasies is baie nader, hulle spasies is baie verder van mekaar. So die water word ons steeds dieselfde gespuit. Name two substances used in crop production that must never be applied through a center pivot irrigation system. Provide a reason for your answer. Jy moet ook twee dinge noem wat ons nooit deur 'n pivot kan hardloop nie. Kunsmis, fertilizers of pesticides. It's a high acid content. Ons kan nie kunsmis en gif wat deur spuit want ons hoë suur binne-in. Acid will corrode the galvanized pipes. Acid gaan hom vreet. Fertilizers with a large particle size. Kunsmis met baie hoë of sorry, dik korrels. Large particles will block the nozzles. Die korrels wat te groot is gaan in die nozzle loop vassit. Dan spuit die water en dan jy weer 'n probleem. Name an easy method for the farmer to communicate with the center pivot to start or stop the irrigation system over a long distance. Hoe kan 'n boer sy spulpunt oor 'n lang afstand, ons sê ek sit in Mamasbury, my spulpunt is op Ketberg, hoe kan ek maar via die selfoon, via selfoons, jy het 'n app for that. You can get an app to spray water, mense, you get an app for everything. Describe briefly the penetrative measures that must be put in place to prevent the system from falling down when one of the wheels gets stuck or the electrical motor that drives the wheel breaks down. When the system gets out of line, a safety switch cuts off the electricity to the wheels, preventing it from the wheels from moving forward. So wat gebeur, kom ons sê, een van die pompe of een van die elektriese motors by die wiel breek, wat gaan ek dan nou een wiel draai nie? Nou gaan my hele stelsel mos nie werk nie. Wat is my failsafe binne in die pivot? Daar is 'n skakelaar wat die krag afsit en dan spuit jy nie verder nie totdat ons hy wiel vervang of regmaak. The spray in the system can easily be blocked by dirt/rust in the pipes. How can this dirt in the pipes be removed effectively without dismantling the whole system? The tap at the end of the system is opened and all impurities in the pipe are flushed out. The tap at the end the tap is then closed and the irrigation system can function effectively. So mense, daar is basies, hoe gaan ek roes in my pype voorkom? Daar is 'n kraan aan die einde van die stelsel wat ek kan oopmaak sodat die water weer vloei. En dan wanneer ons hom weer toemaak, dan werk my stelsel weer perfek. Sprinklers form part of the irrigation system. What is the function of the sprinkler head? The sprinkler head in the photo, wat is die funksie van hierdie kop daarso? Distribute water evenly in the case over large areas. Hierdie ding spuit water oor 'n groot area. Dis sy punt. Dis sy doel. Name two effective materials that used to manufacture the sprinkler head indicated in the picture. Metal, brass or galvanized iron of plastic. So hy kan gemaak word of uit metaal uit of uit plastiek. Onthou dit moet 'n galvanized yster wees of brass, né? Name the advantages of each material used in the previous question that makes it suitable for a sprinkler. Onthou, die metaal, the metal doesn't wear out easily, die metaal breek nie vinnig nie. And the plastic of choice of metals is not corrosive. Mense onthou by plastiek en die sekere keuse van die metale, roesie. Alright, that is our first lesson. And I stop here today with my video. And the next one will follow suit. Alright guys, see you again as quick as possible. Hy mense, gaan hierdie werk deur, sien julle gou weer en wees veilig, né? Hy manne, lekker dag.